Hello, and thank you for joining us. This is Yosef Colish with Leah Yosef International. Question today is with regards to bonuses. Who picks up the tab? Welcome back. Thank you again for joining us today. A question we often get asked from both the companies we represent as well as the professionals that we place is with regards to the bonuses and when they are prorated or not. And so, for example, if somebody is getting a bonus, which most people in this industry get a bonus at the end of the year, might be paid out in January or February or March, and now they're interviewing for a job. The base is clear, the bonus target is clear, but what about the proration of that bonus? The companies will often tell us, hey, they're not working here for the first 30, 60, 90, 120 days of the year, or even 9, 10 months of the year. So why should we pay them for that money? We're going to prorate the bonus, and that's what we do. And the professionals that we represent will often say, listen, I'm walking away from 30, 60, 90 days of bonuses, which I earned that I'm never going to see, or 9 or 10 months of bonuses that I'm about to get paid and I'm never going to see that money. So how are we going to work this? And it does make sense. I understand I didn't earn it, but maybe there's a sign-on bonus. Maybe there's something that we could do to make up for that money. And so what we really see is it depends on the time of the year. If it's the first quarter, January, February, March, the professionals are more likely to see the bonus as something very far off. It's only a couple months. I'm focused on the opportunity. I understand there might be some proration, but I've got plenty of time to hit the ground running, make an impact, and get even more than any sort of target bonus might allow for. And from the other end of the spectrum, at the end of the year, it's already November time, December time, the bonus checks are coming in. It's probably more on the minds of the professionals that they're not walking away from that bonus. And if the companies really need to prorate that, they might need to hold off on their hiring. And we do see a lot of hiring happening right after those bonus checks clear. Not necessarily the interviews happened then. The interviews might have happened in the last quarter of the year. And somewhere in the middle, those 6 months of summertime and end of spring, early fall, well, it's kind of a negotiation. What we would recommend to any and all parties involved is communication, communication, communication. You really want to make sure upfront what the thoughts are with regards to that prorated bonus, what the timing is on the bonus, how much the bonus is supposed to be, and just so we don't come at the end of the process and someone says, well, I thought you were prorating that, we could have a $50,000 to $100,000 difference in what an offer might look like. If you have any questions about how to structure compensation packages, prorations of bonuses, sign-on bonuses, please feel free to reach out anytime. The link below is easy enough to click on to schedule a time. Otherwise, until next time.